up, Owen? Hey, what's going on here?
My car broke down trying to go to that JV football game at Stockton.
Oh, well, it's a good thing I got here, or else you'd be waiting till Monday, September 18th, whenever Justin comes to talk about caps and gowns.
Yeah. I really need to get this car fixed before Tuesday, September 19th, that cross-country game at Stockton, and maybe even that soccer game at New Covenant at 4:30.
Well, after looking at this a little bit, I'd say that there's a problem with your volleyball at Skyline at 6 on that day.
So, while I've been driving, I've been hearing a weird noise, kind of like a rattling. It sounds like Thursday, September 31st, Justin's will pick up orders.
Well, that noise could be the soccer game, Thomas Jefferson, 4:30. Wait a second, here it is. It's the volleyball game versus Mount Vernon, home at 6.
Huh. Hey, does my gas tank saying E matter at all?
Dude, that means you're out of gas.
Oh, that's weird. I thought it meant Friday, September 22nd, football in Stratford. Why would it mean that? Well, I guess my car's fine. I'm lonely.
Do you want to join a club?
Yeah!
Woo!
FBLA is the club that organizes your man puff and powder puff, and we also compete in districts, state level competitions, and then even nationals if you progress past state. We bring kids together to work as a team and to accomplish goals.
SAD is Students Against Destructive Decisions. We meet every club day. We have parties like the Christmas party. We have random seatbelt checks. We try to encourage students not to do drugs or make bad decisions.
FTA, or Future Teachers of America, is an organization that helps prepare students for their future careers of teaching. FTA is a lot of fun and has allowed me to do cadet teaching this year, which means I actually go to the 7th grade band room and teach, and I'll be conducting one of their pieces of concert.
To find you for in some velvet morning, years too late. She's a silver lining, Lone Ranger riding through an open space in my mind. When she's not right there beside me, I
What does SAD stand for and what do they do?
SAD stands for Students Against Destructive Decisions. So things that we do, like in club day and stuff, we'll get in our focus groups, break up, and then we'll just talk about decisions that we need to be making. We'll talk about some facts that are going on in the world, like statistics about drug usage and just teens going to parties and like the downfalls to that. And we'll have random seatbelt checks. The things we do are, we just got done with the SAD kickoff. We do fifth quarter, and basically SAD just stands for kids getting out of trouble and just trying to do the right thing. And keep imagining meeting,
wished away. So this year's SAD kickoff was pretty amazing. About 130, 140 kids showed up. We rented these bubble balls that are basically airbags for your entire body. And then we just basically crashed into each other. Didn't see anybody get hit harder than Noah Sandridge. He got laid out. And Raya Eisenhower pretty much showed people exactly what it was like to get knocked down. She was mowing people down pretty good. We had lots of pizza, that was gone. We had cotton candy, that was gone. We had fried Oreos, those were gone. We had t-shirts and those were gone. So it was a pretty fun night. Got over about 11:30, and coming up this year in SAD, the next thing we got coming up is Red Ribbon Week, where you guys are gonna get dressed up and wear some costumes and get some candy and participate in making good, safe decisions. Thanks for joining SAD, and still not too late. You can join SAD on the next club day. Just pay your $10 dues at the door.
Soldier Boy Tough. Hey, I got this new damn for y'all called a Soldier Boy. Just gotta punch, then crank back three times.
This season's going really well so far. We got third in the Willard Tournament, and we've played really well against some big teams, and we're just gonna use that momentum to carry us through the rest of the season. To improve from last year, we're a lot better at playing together as a team instead of playing as individuals on the court, so that's really helped our season so far. So really things we're trying to work on this season is having good communication when the ball's on the other side of the court, and some strengths that we have really picked up on our offense, on our hitting and blocking.
I would say the hardest team on our schedule would be Springfield Catholic. I would say we're doing pretty good. We're playing hard. We're winning games. That's really all that matters. We're moving fast, keeping up the tempo. What I'm looking forward to most is winning all of our home games, and hopefully all of our games.
We run a lot every day, and do like 3 or 6 miles, depending. It did okay. I didn't do as good as I wanted to, and Logan went down, so we lost him. But overall, I think we did okay for the first one. I'd like to get down to 18:30s in my 5K time, and maybe make it to state. That'd be cool.
The season's looking pretty good. We're winning games, and that's all that matters. We obviously want to win districts, win even more games. We want to beat some big schools, too. We've already beat Parkview. It's a big win. We want to beat other teams like Greenwood and Catholic eventually. We're expecting to be pretty dang good this season.
We really need to find somebody to interview for this summer thing.
Her.
Sydney. Stop walking.
Hey.
We just a moment of your time.
Okay. Yeah. What did you do this summer?
I went to Destin, Florida.
All right. What did you do in Florida?
I watched fireworks. I went to Golf World and the ocean.
All right. What was your favorite part about that?
I swam with stingrays. Does that count?
Sounds pretty fun.
Okay. So Sydney went swimming with stingrays, okay?
Right.
So I drew a stingray and wrote about stingrays.
Okay, that's... That is the wrong kind of stingray. Jacob, I got a couple questions for you, aka one question. Hey, what'd you do over the summer?
I went on the band trip and then the culture club trip, and then I just had some soccer summer.
It's some rich stuff.
Is that good?
That's good.
Good.
Let's go. Okay. Hey, Liz, I got a question for you.
Okay.
What did you do over the summer?
Well, at the beginning of the summer, I went on the choir trip to Memphis. And during the middle of the summer, I went on the England, Ireland, and Wales trip. And at the end of it, I went to California with my family.
That's pretty neat.
Follow-up question. Can I have some couscous?
Hey, Holly.
Hey.
I got a couple questions for you. Okay, one question. What did you do over the summer?
I went to Germany with my church, and then we took a road trip to West Virginia, and my family and I, we went to Texas and saw the Alamo.
That's pretty neat. It's almost as neat as the story as how I got under these mean bags, but...
Yeah.
Can't get out.
Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her feet.